guys. I got my Beyonce tickets. I'm happy. But I'm sick. Illness ensue. So, I'm crusty. I just woke up. I was like, oh, maybe I'll sign in early. And then it was like, oh, you're in the queue. And then it was like, four people ahead of you. And then a second later was like, you're in. And I was like, oh, shoot. Because I was waiting on the email. But I was like, I saw somebody's TikTok that said, go in early or something like that. And just wait. And I was like, I just went to check because I was going to go to the store. And I was like, let me just check before I go to the store. Now I don't have any money for the store. Yeah, so that's that. I'm happy. I'm really excited now. I'm really excited that I get to see Beyonce. I've never gotten to see Beyonce, and I've never gotten myself something that expensive. Why am I crying? Oh, I know why I'm crying. So, but the stupid battery. So I showed you guys my medicine. I started a new medicine. It's the same medicine, but it's a new dosage. It's extended release. And it has my emotions all over the place. My head feels clogged. I feel dizzy. I actually need to take it. It's 11. I need to take it at the same time every day, and I haven't been doing that. I just kind of take it as soon as I wake up. And my sleep is all off. I just feel jittery. I don't feel like myself. I feel icky. I just feel crazy. My anxiety is up. My mood is just awful. Yeah, so I've been crying the past couple of days. I can't necessarily gauge whether my reactions to things are irrational or if they're like my true emotions just coming out. So yeah, it's a bit irritating. I talked to my mom and my sister yesterday. That helped me feel a little better. But I know like my fiance doesn't understand it, and he's very confused and he doesn't know how to deal with emotions. So but I'm not really concerned about him right now, because I need to focus on my own feelings and just get through these first couple of weeks, and hopefully I can just tame it down. My face, it's like my front of my face is just like pressure or something. But I need to go to the store real quick and then come back so I can relax. I need to do my hair today. That's my only task, is to do my hair today, and the grocery store. So I think that's it for this vlog. If I have any other things I want to share about this experience, I'll let you guys know. But that's it for this week's, no, it's not this it for this week's vlog. Today is actually Friday. I want to end the vlog on Sunday because Sunday's Super Bowl and I'm excited to see Rihanna. So yeah, not that I don't have loyalty. I am a girl's girl. Beyonce is always my number one, and I just love her, and I'm just so glad I'll be able to see her in person for the first time. So, and this is like fan from the beginning. The beginning. First grade, second grade. Okay, so this was the no days. So all right, I'll talk to you guys later. Alright, I'm back from the store. I went to Trader Joe's and Albertsons to get like the stuff that Trader Joe's doesn't have. And then I stopped at Starbucks and got me a oat milk shake and espresso. Not really hitting today. Feels like it needs more sweetener or something. And then I also shouldn't be having coffee this late in the afternoon. But looks like that's what we're doing today. I'm gonna show you guys what I got from Trader Joe's. So I'm just gonna grab from the bag. I grabbed some whole grain bread. I thought that they had Dave's colored bread. Maybe they just didn't have it today. That's what I prefer. But yeah, grab some whole grain bread. Shredded cabbage. I was gonna put that in my pho. And then I also think I'm just gonna make it like a side dish of like Trader Joe's has a garlicky cabbage, but I normally make my own, so I'm gonna make that. Staple, which is my shredded kale for lunch. I got some of this vegan pesto. I love this so much. This is so good.
Yeah.
Somebody tried to argue with me on Instagram when I posted this, and they were like, pesto is already vegan. And I'm like, no, it's not. Pesto is made with cheese. So I don't know if they was thinking that, I don't know what they were thinking, but vegan pesto, this is really good. I needed some more minced garlic. I got some peri peri sauce. I've gotten this before, don't really remember, but if you've ever been to Hawaii and been to the Giovanni's shrimp truck, there's these really spicy shrimp, and when I was looking it up, I'm like, these seem like similar ingredients, so I'm gonna put these on like some whole head shrimp that I have. All right, I'm gonna make charcuterie, so I got this triple cream. If you're into brie cheese, this is like the best one. I always look for the one with this flag on it. So yeah, triple cream brie. And then I got some Calabrian chili tomato dumpling soup. I'm like, that sounds interesting. So grab that. Amazing. I love dumplings. I don't know what kind of dumplings this is gonna be. And this is not vegan. Made with milk, eggs, and wheat. Just so you guys know. This, I got the regular Caesar salad. I also got, this is new to me, everyday butter lettuce salad kit with Parmesan cheese, croissant, croutons, and ranch vinaigrette. So that sounded interesting. Still haven't decided what I'm gonna eat right now, but they didn't have the chicken ones, but these are the soup dumplings. I just grabbed the pork because I was craving this. These are one of my favorite things from Trader Joe's. This is new to me as well, the gnocchi alla romana. So it's a four cheesy semolina gratins. I can feel like four pieces in here, but it's good to be used as a side dish. It says like paired with soups and stuff like that. And then I saw somebody say that it tasted like artichoke dip or something like that. Hey, I don't know. Looks like it got a lot of cheesy stuff, but I was just like, whatever. Ricotta and spinach filled ravioli. Another household staple, the vegetable fried rice. Pro tip, get the vegetable one, not the chicken one. The chicken one is kind of weird. Something about the chicken is weird and doesn't cook right with the rest. Just get the vegetable one and add whatever meats you want to it. For the charcuterie, I just got some pepperonis. I prefer pepperoni. So yeah, this is my little pairing of charcuterie. New to me also is this spicy Mexican style rice cauliflower. So I was like, huh, I'll try this out. Been trying to get my vegetables in. And last but not least, chicken tenderloins. Chicken tenders cook a lot better than like chicken breasts to me. And then chicken thighs is kind of, is dark meat, so it kind of has that little dirty taste. Something about this is just the right balance. It's always soft and yeah, I just prefer chicken tenders. I got this beef birria the last time I went. I was looking for another one, but they didn't have one because I see the portion size is pretty small. And I wanted to make some ramen with it. They didn't have the new garlicky ramen either, so whatever. Now this is what I got from Albertsons. Pretty much the junk foods. I asked him what he wanted. I asked him what he wanted from the store, and he said snacks. So these are kind of a, why is this a household? Why is this a household staple? I don't know, but these are good. These Tapatio chips, fire. I got him some Lunchables. This is my little child. This is literally my little child. Pizza Lunchables, which I don't know what the deal is with Lunchable prices right now, but these were 2 for $4. Like, make these $1 and stop playing. Like, oh man. I wasn't paying attention. I got 2 pepperoni and 2 cheese. Oh, well, I bought pepperonis. Boom. Like, I was really penny pinching at the store. And that's, if you know me, like, that is not me at all. Like, I get what I get. But this does, like, this meaning me spending so much money on the Beyonce tickets. It helped me, like, snap back into reality of what I need to be doing in the first place, because I be wilding. I've been wilding for the past year, just like buying stuff. So I'm kind of glad that this helped me narrow things back down, put things back into perspective. I'm grateful that I have the money to be able to get tickets and still be able to feed myself and pay my bills, but it doesn't feel good to spend money like that. So I need to do better at budgeting. Yeah, guys, I took out these leftovers. I made like some shrimp and broccoli. But yeah, I didn't feel dizzy in the store, but it's like you were in your head. It's like, yeah. And I noticed my reaction time isn't as quick as I would like. I'm definitely adding brown sugar to this. Did y'all forget the brown sugar? I taste the cinnamon. I taste the oat milk. I forgot that the camera was rolling the other day when we were talking to my grandma, but pretty much my grandpa isn't doing too well, and we know that the end is coming, and it's obviously very sad for us. This is my first like grandparent that I'll be losing, and it's bittersweet because I was able to see him, and he felt us there and all that kind of stuff. So it was bitter obviously because he's leaving, but I was glad that I was able to see him and that he was able to recognize that we were present with him. Oh, but I'm not getting emotional. I was good. I was good with it. I'm you know, kind of at terms with it. The hard part right now is my grandma. By the way, these containers are amazing from OXO. It's like, here's the container. This is brown sugar. You put it on and then you press it to seal. Press it to open. Like, ain't no, nobody about to get in these. It's funny too how like I pulled out the leftovers because, yeah, this is what I wanted. I need to stop eating out. By the way, I use this because I had, I mean, not I use this. I went to Starbucks because I knew I had money on my like gift card. So it's technically like not using money. And then also the store, I pulled out like one of my gift cards that I have from Christmas, like a Visa gift card that I got. So that was $25. And then I had to use my emergency cash money because I was just didn't want to use my debit card again. That is delicious. Because of this medicine and me being more irritable, I have to make an extra effort to be nice. Which is not a problem. I'm not mean, but if something already irritates you, things that, I mean, if something already irritates you and then you add this medicine on top of that, it's a lot. It's a lot to deal with for me, and it's a lot to put out onto others. So, just being aware and being still responsible for my mouth, I guess. These are the pills that I'm about to take right now. This is the new one. This, extended release Keppra Plaquenil, which I switched to daytime, vitamin C, and I'm missing one. This is vitamin C and vitamin B complex. I want to take my prenatal. This is prenatal. Alright. Look what popped up. That's so exciting. That's so exciting. I'm so excited, y'all. I'm so excited. Just amazing, bro. I'm gonna show you guys what I got from Sephora. I want it all. Face and Eye Total Rejuvenation Set from Beauty Bio. This was actually gifted to me and I'm like so happy. I have no idea. I will have to sit down and look at this. I didn't know that you could microneedle under your eye, because it's a microneedling tool for face. It has eye attachment. So I'm gonna have to look this over, but here it is. I'll put a link down below for
Sephora, because that's where you can get it from, but I actually called this girl I know that works at Beauty Bio, so I called to see if I was going to buy the, like, that face cleaning tool. I forgot what it's called, Hydrafacial or something. I called her to see if it was, like, worth it, like, was it a good product, and she was like, that's really new, so she hadn't even worked with that product yet, but she was like, you know, you can always, like, you know, try it out and then let me know. She basically was like, try it out and let me know. So I guess when she heard that I was interested, she sent me this. So I was like, so happy. But here it is. After you open it up, it's all the tools there and, like, products. This is the Quench eye balm. So yeah, I'm a little nervous about this, so I'm gonna have to read up on this and then I'll let you guys know. I'm actually planning on doing, like, a whole skincare video. I haven't done that yet. So she also sent me some Super Goop. I love Super Goop so far. This is the glow screen and this is the unseen sunscreen. So I believe I actually have these, the mini versions. So it's cool that I have a large to put in my cabinet for my everyday use. Now, I ran when this was back in stock. This is the Laura Mercier Creme Brulee. I'm gonna smell this for the first time on camera. This is a body cream, by the way. I've been, like, having this on my wish list for, like, a year now, and it's always sold out, even on Laura Mercier's website. So, here's what it looks like. I thought it was going to be bigger, but it's pretty decent size. I don't smell anything yet. Oh my gosh. Y'all, it smells so good. Ooh, it smells almost like buttercream, like I want to taste it. Not as thick as I'm used to for body butters, but it smells yummy. It kind of does have a little bit of a, you know, that fake after smell? I feel like it definitely would be good layered with like some vanilla type of perfume. It's something about it that's off for me. It smells a really good, but yeah, it has like a after kind of scent that's throwing me off. Like, I thought it would be a little more perfumish. Why does it have red 33 in it? And yellow 5, yellow 6. I'm gonna take this back, y'all. Excuse me. It smells really good. There's no doubt. Like, it smells good, but it's not. Maybe it's my skin. It's giving Bath and Body. I'm not gonna even lie. Put my mouth in it. Like, from here, it smells really good. Okay, stop eating it. Yeah. Something about it's not right. I might take this back. It's not giving what I thought it was going to give. I really wanted to love this. And then I got the Sephora Favorites, the luxury one. Luxury favorites. So I was like, I've been into my luxury products lately, and I'm like, run it up. I just noticed the quality difference. Like, once you get to that, like, next level, like, you kind of get what I'm saying. But ooh, Givenchy, that's really cute. So you plug out. A little lipstick. Givenchy Rose Perfecto Lip Balm, 24-hour hydration. Very smooth. Feels like really moisturizing, actually. And 001 Pink Irresistible. Yeah, that definitely, I was trying to be gentle with it because it is a mini. Nice little pinkish lip balm. This here is Pat McGrath. It looks like a eyeliner, a liquid eyeliner. Felt tip point. Pat McGrath, we love her. Perma Precision Liquid Eyeliner in Extreme Black. We love that. The next one is from Gucci. What do you got for me, Gucci? Gucci. Mascara. Oh, look at that wand. Here's what the wand looks like. It's actually pretty interesting. I don't think I've seen a wand like that. Smells like mascara. Lash by Lash Buildable Volume in Eve Black. We have us a grab and go mascara. And then the last thing is from Armani. Yeah. Giorgio Armani. It's a Lip Maestro in shade 524. This is what it looks like. I think it's a twist top. That's what I feel like. Yeah. It's twisting off. Like a plumish color. You don't want to try this out? Might as well. That color, like, did y'all see the way that color went on, though? Alright, that's it for this collection. This was $65. Apparently a $200 value. But, yeah, I like little favorites and stuff like this to give you, like, a tester of, you know, different products. So, this is on Sephora's website as well. I'll link it if it's on Amazon, but, you guys want to try this out. And then last thing I got, I used 500 of my points to get a little travel Laura Mercier. I thought it was like the small one, but it's a tiny one. But this will do, something to keep in your purse, a little powder. So I can add that to my little minis collection. Next up is, I ordered this directly from Fenty. So I'm excited about this because, yeah, I missed the last drop of the body butter, the shimmer one. So I ordered it from Fenty. If something is out of stock on Sephora's website or Ulta or whatever, go to the brand's website and see if they have it. They had this on the website. So I guess we're doing a first of this one. Trying to slip it off of the case just in case I do decide to take it back. But all right, here it is. This color is giving. Now this is what that's supposed to smell like. Right. All right, let's see how it is on the skin. Yeah, this is it. Was this one supposed to shimmer? It's not shimmering, so is it? No, it's not shimmering. Yeah, this smells amazing. Laura's going back. Always bet on black. Wow. We redid that. Yeah, that's great. So, by the way, this is the Butter Drop Vanilla Dream Whipped Body Oil. Okay, I was expecting shimmer, but I guess I missed the last shimmer drop. But that smells great. I'm happy. Very happy. Now, the next thing I got It's the Body Duo. They had a, this is the original butter drop. So I was like, I needed another small one. And then this one came with the mini body scrubs. I was like, why not? Buff Rider exfoliating body scrub. Oh, that smells so good. This is what Fenty is giving when you order from the website. And that is it. I'm about to do my hair. I have two options. I need to wash my hair regardless, so I need to, because I have product at the top. So I can either wash it and braid it down and do a quick weave, and that'll be like my Valentine's / birthday hair. Or I can just press my regular hair, like still washing everything, blow dry, and then press my normal hair and just wear it natural. And I feel like that's gonna be the move, because I don't wanna put nothing tight on my head right now, since my head, I have like these mini headaches and just kind of tension. So for my hair, I'm trying to finish up these products. Pretty much almost done, but I've been using this Camille Rose. I really like this, and I've had this for a long time, like, and then I was using the conditioner just kind of as a leave-in, but this is the Moroccan Pear Conditioning Custard. So this is nothing in here. I might as well just toss this. Yeah, there's nothing left. And then this is the Sweet Ginger Cleansing Rinse. At first I was like, what the heck is a cleansing rinse? Because I'm used to like the word shampoo, but that's what it is. It's a shampoo. So I'm gonna pull this out. This is the Mayel hair mask. So I'm gonna finish up this and use this, and then once that's done, I'll move over to my Mayel products.
Bruh, I'm sick.
Me sick.
Spending that money was very hard.
Oh, you did it.
Yes. $12.50. But
that's including all the fees and everything?
Yeah.
That's not bad. How much was the...
What you mean it's not bad?
How much was the ticket? Especially if you got extra clothes.
I got close enough. Like, I'm not on the floor because I wasn't paying $2,000. I was like, it's just that was...
$2,000 just for the ticket?
For all the fees and stuff to get a floor. And I was like, I'm good with just getting that first. I'm pretty much at the first level.
What, close like a mezzanine or something?
No, like, I mean, what is a mezzanine?
Where's that?
Vegas, the Legion.
Oh, at the Raiders Stadium.
Yeah. So I'm pretty much the floor. I'm the first one up.
The ball.
The first section of the ball, closest I could to the stage.
I mean, closest you could.
So you know how like it goes around. The stage is here. I'm like here.
On the side.
On the side.
Sure.
Because.
How close is your seat?
I got as close as I could. I felt a little better after on Twitter, because people were saying that the Vegas tickets are way more than other places. That's why I paid so much.
Because the brand new stadium and shit.
So they were like, yeah. And then I figured that weekend in Vegas is probably gonna be crazy. Like, yeah. So I'm good.
She bring people up?
Sometimes.
August 26th?
Yep. While I bust it for you, baby. Oh, baby. Alright, I'm gonna let this sit for... Ooh, do I even got a shower cap? I don't. It's just gonna stay like this. I'm gonna let this sit for 20 minutes. That's that hair mask. This is my hair. Let's see if I can get it. It's really long. But I guess if I get product on my
Hopefully it doesn't break me out, but. In the back. It's giving. It's giving. I might do clip-ins for summer. Yeah, I'm gonna let that sit. I'm gonna do 15 minutes since it's been on about 5 minutes. Here's the blow dryer. So this is the Knot Doctor, by the way. I guess that's what it's called. It's by Infinity Pro Conair to connect this. This was kind of a game changer for me, but before my hair dries, I need to move quickly. I'm using this IC leave-in hair and scalp treatment. I just kind of go there, massage it into my scalp. And then whatever else is left, I just drag it onto the hair. And it's just leave-in. Look at that. Alright. It's done. I'm gonna kind of just section it off. I think I'm just gonna split it in half. And then I'm gonna braid it. I don't know what I just did, but. And then this section, I am gonna do in half. I guess I could have did the other one in half, but.
What's crazy is I feel pretty relaxed on Friday. Normally on Fridays I get anxious because I know I have things to do Saturdays. But as nervous as I was a different type of nervous, so. Got my little Felicia braid.
And now it's time to tackle this part. So. This blow dryer is getting kind of hot, so I am gonna add a heat protectant. This is from Shea Moisture. I've had this for a long time, but yeah, I feel like I need a heat protectant. Yeah, and it's all stopped up.
So let's use that.
Alright. Alright, we are all done. Pretty limp, but whatevs. It's what I wanted. I need to do these nails. Alright, hair is all done. Since chemo, it definitely is thinner, but my hair was always pretty thin, so this feels about normal. It did get really long, but I know that I need to cut like probably to about here. So I'm gonna wrap it. I actually wanted to do wand curls, so it could be like get some fullness. I might do that for like Valentine's Day or something, but that's it for now. I will see y'all on Sunday. Bake and wrap some shrimp. And you're cooking. What's this stuff?
I'm glad you fit me too. There's tons of holes in the defense. There's a ton of
holes in the defense. That's ridiculous.
It's a third down, great dialed up pressure, and Jalen Hurts just works the magic.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, we're in trouble.
Just get the playoff.
Get it. Look. Hey, get it. Look. Get the ball.
Hey, her birthday. Birthday over. Nelly's birthday.
1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Who's that?
Cake. Cake?
You gotta wait. They're gonna cut it.
Yummy.
Yummy.
No.
Who's that?
Can you step back? There's a girl here.
Everybody been falling.
Come on, we have another play.
I'd like to go back and take a look at that.
Yeah, because he didn't have that one either.
I think he double caught that ball, and by the time he caught it again, so he catches it. Now watch the ball come loose. His left foot's down.
She's looking.
Oh, it's really close whether that left foot was still on the ground when he caught it following the bobble.
Y'all gonna take a whole ass touchdown away. Y'all gonna take that away.
She was looking.
Do it again.
You two in the making?
Let's go,
Eagles. Mom, did you watch my video today? Oh, I thought she was still right.
Defense needs time to match up, and we did not allow that.
Where'd everybody go? Where'd everybody go? Hi, baby.
Hello.
Who's that, Cheyenne?
It's considered a substitution. The defense
you don't know?
To match up.
After I think it's Naomi.
Which one is this?
You got Marvel?
Naomi.
Okay.
Hi, Naomi.
That's it. Jose couldn't run the play.
Oh, Andy Reid
has some ability to challenge, as Mike said, so now he will. Mike, why did this call get upheld here?
As Carl Sheffield described it, watch the left toe still on the ground, right hand on the ball, then gets the right foot down. So really very close, as is the one in the first half, but not there's enough to the turn.
Yeah, and
Carl Sheffield
is in a challenge and a timeout there, and then there's this. That was 3rd and 14 for the
Eagles. It's the sauce bar.
Because Nick Sirianni chose not to call time.
Some juice.
Take the 5-yard delay.
I didn't even
game,
make my own buffalo sauce.
Which tells you you need to know about how Nick Sirianni values those
who's that?
Knowing that probably need
that.
That's
Malcolm.
That
he said me.
Sanders. Keep pulling it back out.
Such an interesting thought to not take a timeout there, yeah, take a delay of game, but obviously worked out in their favor, right? I mean, you don't see that very often.
No, you don't, but what teams are realizing now is those blown timeouts.
Why
did
you throw away the process?
You got to play in late, you got to substitute.
Are you going to record the TV?
I'm recording our reaction, so everybody's going to do it.
Oh, wait. I'm the cue, my lipstick out. Uh-oh. Is this it? Oh, mama.
Who's the commercial?
A Trojan horse?
We should open the gate.
Let's see what's going on. At Crowdstrike, we wanted to truly
celebrate this in time and prevent
this before they happen to keep your business from becoming
a hit.
It's not flat. Flat. You guys keep saying it. It's came back up.
What are you doing?
Huh?
Looking at the dog.
That's Creed. That's gonna be so good.
I fell asleep on the other Creed. And that's before.
I guess they're not that exciting. Creed. I liked all of them, but I can't see how you fell asleep.
I've seen them all. That have no correlation. I remember the girl was deaf, and I was like, why he pick a deaf girl when he could be with me?
She's like, what?
I think I saw the phone.
Look, everybody. Is this here?
I can't eat. Where the baby at? Where's Jack?
Oh, she ready, y'all.
Turn it up. Yeah.
That is scary.
Is she Keisha?
She might be, she looks very little bit.
Okay?
That's 9 months.
No toy.
She want a baby.
She got your baby.
No, this one wouldn't have been my guess.
She pregnant? Or she fat?
She might be, y'all.
Because
9 months postpartum.
She's pregnant again.
It's like a pregnant belly, huh? I'm not being Oh, 7 halftime show. After the game, go to NFL.com/livevisualhour to watch all of tonight's Super Bowl 57 performances.
Thank you for watching this presentation of the National Football League.
I'm here with world champion Deanna Flores. Deanna, you are so elusive. Is there anyone that can pull your flag?
Oh, you stay in the room.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's all about the sauce. We gotta run.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. On channel 9.
Happy 13th birthday,
Cheyenne. Happy 13th
birthday, little baby.
Big.
Yay.
Okay.
I wish 13. For more robots.
13, okay. Enough. Don't buy no robots. Robots? Are you pass that down because you're 13?
No, she not done.
Well, excuse me.
What'd you get, Cheyenne?
I'm gonna get another cake for Sunday. You want cake this time or you want cake Sunday? You want both?
She said she not eating cake till Sunday, right?
Yeah, I think I'll wait till Sunday.
Okay.
I think I'll be a good girl.
I'm
got Robux too.
No, don't you want that?
I think I know which came from what.
Trying to get rid of the cake.
I was going home and have a salad.
She walked towards
and some chicken in a bowl in there. I'm looking for chicken salad. I think so. I was going to have a salad.
Get you one of these.
Huh?
It's a chicken salad.
What?
It's on the internet.
She'd
be a stupid.
Oh, she'd be a stupid. Okay.
She'd have to get you one of these. Just talk to the store.
From where?
What's
she doing?
The chicken salad. From where?
She was calling to talk to Cheyenne, but we couldn't get her.
Oh, we should have called her back to when we said happy
birthday.
Oops.
We can do it again.
Well, Declan probably knocked
down,
huh?
No, he was just on the phone.
Oh, he was?
Ooh. All the things that make you. Happy birthday. Thank you.
You have them baby cakes.
Oh, Sia, this is what we got her.
Yay!
Look, it says, guess what?
Happy birthday,
girl. Hi.
Happy birthday.
Get off me. Thank you.
Oh, I'm good.
Thank you. I didn't say that.
You didn't read it.
I just dropped by. I just left the hospital, so I just dropped by. To wish Shasha a happy birthday.
We got her these.
Do y'all want a piece of cake?
No, you wasn't. I bought that today.
She knew.
Oh, never mind. Hi, Declan.
Hey, happy birthday,
Shasha. That's not Cheyenne. That's Cheyenne. Mama sent a happy birthday Chanel today. You said wrong daughter, Mom. The picture does look like me though.
Keep it up and you gon' lose all the shit that we've been through. You must think that.